Elevator codes can be complicated, and now with code updates from ASME and IBC, emergency communications inside of your elevator require even more. Here we have a quick chat with Dave Mann, our Vice President of Technology, about the genesis of our CabView solution.
I started at a central station when I was 18 years old. I worked third shift and I was an operator. Quickly developed a talent for technical aspects of the job, so I got into the technical department at the first place that I worked. I was there for 8 years. I moved to another central station in North Carolina where my role there was purely technical, and I spent 13 years there. Moved to another town and worked at another central station for 2 years. I went on to my own career as a consultant back to the central station industry before coming to Kings 3. And I've been at Kings 3 now for 8.5 years. CabView began as a code discussion with ASME. We learned that the code that ASME was developing was a direct result of the code that IBC had already published, and ASME was working on the rule base for what it was going to be like for elevator companies to have to include new technologies in the elevators. CabView itself is more of a response to the manufacturers who created the devices that will go into the elevators to enable the features that ASME 2019 requires. And for us, CabView rounds out because we provide the monitoring for those devices here at Kings 3 in the Emergency Dispatch Center. For the ASME 2019 solution, that requires the elevator company install their own equipment for the video and the messaging piece. This is because it's integrated in with the controls of the elevator itself. Kings 3 does still provide the phone, and Kings 3 does provide the monitoring service for the phone and all of the video and messaging components. With CabView, the customer has two options for the data connection, and that is provide it themselves or have Kings 3 provide that. Prior to the ASME 2019, the customer deliverable for the emergency communications in the elevator cab was a phone line, because they simply had to provide connectivity for a phone. Phone lines are simple and easy. They've been the same for 100 years. And when the customer orders that, they're basically getting a very simple connection from their elevator directly to the phone company. Those connections aren't used for anything else, and it's a very simple thing. Now, with the addition of the video and the messaging piece, we can't do that through a phone line anymore. There has to be a data connection. So now the customer deliverable becomes a data connection. And this is where things get complicated, because a data connection means a connection into their network and then ultimately out to the internet. I think the concern that most customers are going to have about having third parties on their network is they don't have real control over what those third parties are doing or the things that they're putting on their network. The concern is that there could be a breach or an unauthorized access to that third party piece of equipment, and then from that third party piece of equipment that the bad actor has a way to get into the rest of the network and do things that are not beneficial for the customer. Because most customer networks are casual networks, most customers don't really give much consideration when they have a problem to reset the router or reset a switch. And what they may be not considering is when they're doing that is the entire time that that router is disconnected from the internet, they don't have emergency phone service. Their ASME 2019 solution will not work. The video won't work, the messaging won't work, and if somebody presses the button in the elevator, we may not be able to connect to that elevator through the video portion or send messages to it. So it's been our position that in order to save the customer the overhead of connecting another device to the network, potentially creating another security concern is to erase those concerns for the customer by providing a cellular data connectivity piece that is solely and strictly for video and the messaging component for ASME 2019. I think what has CabView standing apart from other solutions in the marketplace isn't so much the equipment that's being installed in the elevator, it's the monitoring aspect. The Emergency Dispatch Center here at King's 3 specializes in elevator monitoring. And because of that speciality, we're very well geared for this. Other central stations or other elevator companies don't necessarily have the same infrastructure that we have. We have double redundancy at our primary site, and in the event that we lose our primary site for any reason, we have a second site that can operate the entirety of the EDC there. And I think that's what sets us apart.